drink from the well of yourself and begin again. Good afternoon, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting from all over Mother Earth. This Cassidy to the portal of the Casa de Dom Ignacio, the house of love, where the medicine is love, here in Abidjania, in the heart of Brazil. And we have another magnificent day here, this gift from God, to learn the lessons we have come here on earth to learn in these physical bodies. This morning here, we started off very overcast, cool, fresh morning with the wind rustling the reeds in the valley. So many beautiful flowers of all different colors and perfumes. In this, the month of the Divine Mother, the month of May, birds serenading us. And now we have beautiful, deep blue skies, the color of Mother Mary's mantle of comfort, and fluffy white clouds passing by slowly, reminding us always of our impermanence. We are just travelers here on earth, and this too will pass. So as we dedicate ourselves to this sacred work, try to be as comfortable as you possibly can. If you're on a crystal bed, relax, connecting with these beautiful casa crystals, multiplying the light on earth. And if you prefer to sit upright with our heads elevated just a little, so this energy can flow fluidly, freely, and easily through each and every one of us, like a river, a current of love and light. And as we close our physical eyes and leave the material world behind, we open our spiritual eyes and connect with our true home beyond the veil. We have so much help from the other side. All of these beautiful entities of light and love are here for us, sent by our Creator to help us, guide us, protect us, and love us. Trust, have faith, and believe in all of these spiritual helpers. They too had bodies once or twice, so they know all about the human condition. They know all about us. They see our suffering, and they know exactly what we need. Today, we pay our respects to the water of the cosmos. water is indeed an essential entity all unto itself. The body of water covers 71% of Mother Earth in seas and oceans. Water is the mother of life. Our bodies are over 80% water. The more we understand water, the more difficult we will find it to deny the existence of God. Water is sacred, miraculous. It nourishes our crops and in turn nourishes our bodies, keeping us alive. The reflection, refraction, and dispersion of light in water drops results in rainbows. And of course, not forgetting the chasm water is vibrating at a very, very high level. And very often the entity recommended chasm water as medicine. And used it for physical interventions. And all of the world's religions use water for purity and cleansing. So it brings us all together. The Christians use holy water for baptism, blessing of people, places, objects, and it repels evil. And water cleanses us, mind, body, and spirit. Masuro Muto wrapped a piece of paper with words typed on it around bottles of water. And this magnificent, beautiful crystal in today's picture is a reaction to the words love and gratitude. This crystal is perfection itself. And it indicates that love and gratitude are fundamental to the phenomenon of life in all of Mother Nature. Reminding us time and time again that everything in the universe, without exception, has a vibration. Everything is interrelated, interconnected, all part of the same shining web. We are vibration. As we raise our vibration here and now in these challenging times on Earth, we naturally in turn raise the vibration all around us. We are called to do this sacred work on the planet. We are making a huge difference. Your love and your light are changing the world forever for the better. And we need to change to become more compassionate, more loving, more grateful, more forgiving, more at peace and harmony with all of creation, of which each and every one of us is an integral part of. And as we honour this gift from God, we are reminded that water is the mirror of our souls. Water has memory and carries within it our thoughts, words, our prayers. And as you yourselves are water, no matter where you are, your prayers will be carried to the rest of the world. And God hears all of our prayers and answers them. Let us pray with open hearts, trustingly, without ceasing, joyfully, happily. The Lord's Prayer, from its original Aramaic. O birther, father, mother of the cosmos, sacred trinity of innumerable names, you create all that moves in light. Focus your light within me now and make it useful. As rays of a beacon show the way, create your reign of unity now through my fiery heart and willing hands. Your one desire then acts with mine, as in all light, so in all forms. Grant what I need each day in bread and insight, subsistence for the call of growing life. Loosen the cords of errors binding me, as I release the stranglehold of others' guilt. Do not let surface things delude me. Liberate me from what holds me back from my true purpose. From you is born all ruling will, the power and the life to be, the song that beautifies everything as it renews from age to age. Truly, power to these words. May they be the source from which all of my actions grow, sealed in trust and in faith. And so be it. Amen. To our Divine Mother Mary, the Mother's Heart, the Feminine Power, Mother Earth. Water, the mother of life. We ask you in this sacred moment to intercede for us, your children, to somehow alleviate the suffering of humanity, helping us all to keep our hearts open, which is our mission on earth, and to find the peace, the harmony, the tranquility, the compassion, the love, the forgiveness, the gratitude deep, deep within us. And it is within all of us. We are divine beings, helping us all, carnate and disincarnate, on our healing journey back home, merging into the light. One heart, one soul, one light, one love. Hail Mother, who art the earth. Hallowed be thy soil, rocks and flora that nourish and support all life. Blessed be thy wind that gives us breath, and thy waters that quench, bathe and refresh all living things. Holy Mother Earth, as one heart, we praise your majesty, grace, and wonder. Amen. And as we bask in this magnificent high vibration of love and gratitude this afternoon, this crystal clear energy pouring from on high into our open hearts, all is in divine order. You are exactly where you're meant to be, here now, in this moment, in time, in a human body, on earth. We are shifting dimensions. It's a holy shift. Painful endings are bright new beginnings. We were born for these times. We have chosen to be here. We are equipped with everything we need and more to walk the path of the light. And we're all in this together, brothers and sisters, in the light. We're just walking each other home. We are resonating more and more with all of creation. Very, very fluid. Like water, this gift we have received from God Almighty. And we have time in these quiet moments to really reflect on our lives. This great pause. We ask for favors and God gives us opportunities. We have this wonderful opportunity to really take stock and get our priorities right. We take so much for granted in this paradise of earth that we have been given. We need to stay elevated and be in a state of gratitude as we consider the element of water. The water element embodies the powers of emotion, communication and cleansing. It encourages adaptability and strength by teaching one to follow the paths of least resistance. Yet water's apparent gentleness is deceptive. Over time, water can wear down the greatest mountains or carve deep canyons through solid rock. The element of water can be invoked to cleanse and purify the aura, washing away all stagnant energies. Though gentle, the energy of water cleans deeply and can remove ingrained patterns or traumas from the energy field. Water is a cooling influence and can counteract the effects of an overabundance of fire energy. It is a powerful ally to call upon when one wishes to strengthen the feminine aspect of one's nature. It encourages receptiveness and is therefore a valuable energy for those wishing to more fully develop intuitive abilities. Water is also a conductor of energy. When we are in resonance with this elemental force, we become better energy receptors and conductors. Water may be speaking to you of the flow of energy in your life. Are you desperately trying to hang on to outmoded aspects of your life? Or are you floating peacefully along with the current, trusting that the universe will deliver you to a better shore? Is your life the rush and fury of whitewater rapids, or the peaceful eddy of a deep and serene pool? If you watch the stream of your life closely, you will see that there is always a balance between the rushing and the quiet. Call upon the energy of water to aid you in finding the balance of movement and stillness in your life. The chakras of water are the heart and the throat. I am supported and transported by the universal flow. in his spiritual exercises, uses the analogy of water to help us to recognize the positive in our lives. He tells us, as we continue to make progress in the spiritual life, the movement of the good spirit is very delicate, gentle, and often delightful. The good spirit touches us in the way that a drop of water penetrates a sponge. When the evil spirit tries to interrupt our progress, the movement is violent, disturbing, and confusion. The way that the evil spirit touches into our lives is more like water hitting hard upon a stone. We are learning a lot from the entities, from our connection with the Casa, and for taking this time to dedicate ourselves to the work of the light. We are much more than we think. We are spiritual beings having a human experience, and not the other way around. We are not the body. We're so much more. The body merely houses our eternal spirits. Our bodies are made up of different elements. Air moves us. Fire transforms us. Water shapes us. Earth heals us. And spirit gives us life. Remember, you are water. Cry, cleanse, flow, let go. Remember that you are fire. Burn, tame, adapt, ignite. Remember that you are air. Observe, breathe, focus, decide. Remember that you are earth. Ground, build, produce, give. Remember that you are spirit. Connect, listen, know, and be still. And as we bask in this glorious high vibration of gratitude and love, this magnificent day, we are now open to receive after giving of our positive loving energies. Thank you so much, brothers and sisters. This is beautiful work. The rewards are immeasurable. We are now receiving a deep, deep, deep cleansing from these beautiful entities of light and love. This is a unique opportunity in these moments to let go of anything and everything that no longer serves us, not only from this lifetime, but indeed past lifetimes, known or unknown to us, as we surrender all of our problems, our anxieties, our fears, our pain, our hurt, our grudges, our resentments, all of our issues over to our Creator, the Architect of the cosmos, transmuting all of this denser energy into divine light as we become lighter, happier, healthier, stronger, more at peace and harmony with all of creation, of which each and every one of us is an integral part of. If you'd like to visualize a waterfall, like the waterfall here at the Casa de Dom Ignacio, or any place of sacred running water that you know, with all the gifts of Mother Nature, sacred, miraculous, gorgeous water. Big blue butterflies helping us with our transformation. Birds of paradise serenading us in a divine symphony. Strong green oak trees cleansing our oxygen. Carpets of magnificent, brilliant, colourful, fragrant flowers. Brilliant sunshine. And crystal clear waters embodying rainbows of light. Let's all go to this beautiful place together. Bring your family and friends with you. And bring those you need to forgive and those who need to forgive you. This is a time of true forgiveness, of surrendering anything, everything that's holding us back, stopping us from becoming the beautiful light beings that we truly are. Our very essence, recognizing that we are love and we are light, that is all there is. And let's bring John of God into this high vibration also. And anybody who has suffered and is suffering on account of the problems at the Casa. And not forgetting our brothers and sisters without their physical bodies who need to be liberated into the light, extending this magnificent high vibration to them also. Every being deserves to be healed, whether we have a body or not. And as we receive this magnificent high vibration from on high, let's share it with our brothers and sisters all over Gaia, allowing it to pour forth into all hospitals, helping our angel doctors and nurses and anyone who's on the front line, caring. Allowing it to gush forth into nursing homes, helping our elders, into hospices, orphanages, prisons, asylums, anywhere and everywhere on planet Earth where our brothers and sisters are suffering or in pain or are hungry. Allowing this beautiful energy to pour forth into the war zones, bringing peace and harmony in our lifetime, remembering the words of Saint Rita of Cassia, to God all things are possible. Pouring forth into the migrant camps helping to liberate our brothers and sisters, recognizing we're all the same, equal, no difference, all part of the same shining web, the God consciousness. Allowing this God light to pour forth into the consciousness of our government leaders, helping them to make good decisions about our future and the future for future generations to come. Helping them to realize the sanctity of life. Putting people before profit. Allowing this gorgeous, pristine, crystal clear energy to pour forth into our ecosystems, regenerating, nourishing, healing. Already Mother Earth is recovering. Hallelujah. Praise God. This beautiful high vibration to envelop Mother Earth, growing, multiplying, cleansing and healing all beings, carnate and disincarnate, as it gushes forth into the universe endlessly.
Thank you.
love and gratitude we receive these celestial blessings, pouring into our open hearts from on high, nourishing us, liberating us, giving us everything we need and much, much more to walk the path of the light on earth in these challenging times. Thank you, God Almighty. For your gift of sacred, miraculous, beautiful water. The mirror of our souls. Water is the mother of life. Thank you, God, for giving us life. Thank you to all these beautiful entities of light and love with us every step of this journey. And thank you, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting together as one family from all over Mother Earth to love and to serve in all things for the greater glory of God. Oh Lord, one tiny bit of water rests on the palm of my hand. I bring it to you, and with it I bring the whole ocean. This tiny drop has the power to ease the burning thirst of men. When spread on the earth, to give life to the seed and the future harvest. When poured on the fire to quench the blaze. A tiny drop of water can cleanse the whole of my impurity when blessed by your forgiveness. O Lord, more than all of this, this tiny drop of water passed over my head is the symbol of my birth in you. Love, loving, love. Namaste.